That's all I really need to check here. Let's go straight to the biolab and then we'll go into the dojo. And that should be it. You don't want to check these? So instruction manual, you can find the alternatives. Chemical saddle lamps, ozone generator. Simply insert the cadaver. Instruction manual for the fridge. Yeah. Insert the cadaver. So. What do you mean you have no idea? You just read the thing. You have to insert something inside. Oh, whatever. Oh, Torgo, so this is where you were. Oh my gosh, no, that's not it at all. I thought maybe you'd found a clue. Calm down, Torgo. Nobody's gonna say that. I'm not sure I can disagree with that. Well, I don't think there are any clues here, so maybe I'm gonna get going. Yep. Say again. There's a bunch of wooden lockers in here. I found a clue in here, but it's just a mastermind's attempt to frame Kyoko. Okay. Well then. Mal, are you ready? It's time. The final showdown.
This is a school announcement. Is everyone working hard? Is your investigation coming along nicely? Well then, since you're all giving it your best, your generous headmaster will give you a little hint. For those of you who are interested, please make your way to the gym ASA possible.
What? Now he wants to give us a hint? It's suspicious, no, there's no doubt about that. This could be a trap. But even knowing that, he's set to go to the gym, right? Oh, hey Hiro. Makoto? Why Jack so surprised? Oh, no reason. You heard Monokuma's announcement, right? Are you here to find out what he has to say? I just did, actually. I'm on my way out. You already talked to him? What'd he say? Listen, sorry, but I gotta go. Hiro, wait. No point in trying to stop him. He ran off like a frightened animal. Hiro? It was like he was trying to avoid me. I was hoping to talk to him about the notebook I found in the locker. Has he been hiding something this whole time? Hello, welcome, welcome, hello. Are you ready for your final hint? Well, it just so happens to be an envelope on the ground in front of you. The envelope? This must be the envelope. And just so you know, I won't be answering any questions about what you find inside. What? Don't worry, just get on with it. Monocrom's cryptic words didn't make me feel any better, but I picked up the envelope and opened it. What I found was a single photograph. It featured a bunch of faces I recognized extremely well. Oh wow. Nice picture, and of course you can't see Junko's face, eh? But we can see Mokuro's. Heh, good thing I have this. Yeah, they got the same face. Sort of, kind of. Same eyes. ASA possible. Oh man, I don't want to wait for another day. Not when I'm so close. It was everyone who came to Hope's Peak at the same time as me. Wait, but there's someone behind Sayaka. She's the only one I don't recognize. Wait, that's not true. I do recognize her. That's right, when Kaiba and I were in the headmaster's room when we looked at that file. Mokuro Ikusaba? Then this girl is... What? Why? Why is Mokuro here with everyone else? And even more than that. Just having everyone pose like this is weird enough by itself. We're all wearing matching uniforms. I don't remember anything like this. Wait, where's Makoto? Oh, I see what he's done! Makoto is probably part of the picture, but they doctored him out, so he's not there. And so everyone will think, oh, Makoto's head, the mastermind. Because they probably think he wasn't part of the original. I see. Clever trick. And then, now that I'm looking at it, it's not even everyone. I know, right? Chihiro's actually a guy anyway, but still. Celeste still wearing her old casual, like Lolita, Gothic Lolita stuff. I'm the only one that's not there. The picture's all 15 other students, but not me. I'm not in the picture. But I guess that makes sense. After all, I don't remember ever taking a picture like this. Went to junior high with Sayaka, but the first time I met everyone else was when I arrived here at Hope's Peak Academy. But you should be in a registry. So it's natural for me not to be in this picture, but it's definitely unnatural. Is that everyone else is in the picture. I thought everyone was like me and didn't know each other till they got here. But if this picture is real, then could that mean, could it be? Everyone else? Just me? Everyone here except me is...
What are you gonna do?
But... I told you, I'm not feeling it. I guess that means he's done talking. Damn it. So in the end, what I found in the gym was even more confusion. And with that confusion in hand, I left the gym dejected. How does that count as a hint? It just made me even more confused. Is that what Monokun was going for? Did he put together a fake photo just to confuse me? But it all looked so real, so full of life. How could anyone fake that? Which would mean everyone but me. Maybe I should just ask everyone directly. That should clear this all up. No, I have to clear all this up. So this is where you've been hiding. Listen, I was hoping to talk to you.
Makoto?
Sorry, gotta go.
What?
She ran off so fast I didn't even have time to ask her to stop.
Hina.
Why?
Why won't you talk to me?
Oh my gosh, this controls are trash.
I mean, hopefully Kaiba has a brain and is what read through the whole registry and seen that he was there, so.
Oh, Kaiba.
Listen, do you think we could talk?
Kaiba?
I have nothing to talk to you about.
Don't talk to me as if we're friends.
Hey, Kaiba, wait.
But of course he didn't. He just walked away.
What the?
Why is he acting like that?
Of course. It's like he was purposely trying to avoid me.
Okay, so even he doesn't have a brain. Maybe Kyoko's the only one with a brain.
Hey, Hiro.
Makoto.
What's going on with you? Every time I see you, you freak out like that.
No. Sorry, but I'm in a big hurry.
Once again, he ran off like a terrified rabbit.
Hiro, what's wrong?
I still wasn't able to talk to him about the notebook I'd found.
It's like he was avoiding me. Like he was afraid of me.
Why? Was the bio lab, right?
Yes.
I decided to visit the bio lab one more time. The first thing I saw when I got there was her passed out again.
Huh? Toko?
It's open. Oh, but no.
Toko, are you okay?
No. She's not dead, is she?
Ugh. It's cold. It's super cold. It's so cold, I think I might catch a cold.
If you keep taking naps in places like this, I'm sure you will.
What? I was asleep?
Ah, I must have fainted again.
I bet you were standing there staring at me getting all excited, weren't you?
No, I wasn't.
Oh, then what?
Hot and bothered? Straight up the whole horny? Okay, so why did you pass out?
I don't know. Last thing I remember was me waking up just now. What'd you do to Miss Morose?
Oh, that's right. Your memory stops and starts each time you switch.
Bingo bazinga. We share some basic knowledge, but our memories are very much separate.
You SOB?
Anyways, oh, SOB, yeah, okay. And don't say it like it's a bad thing, I'm a blessing as far as I'm concerned. Cause even if she forgets something, I totally remember. So it's like double the memory.
No, it's more like half.
Okay, why?
But all I wanna know right now is, where's my little darling? Tell me now or I slit your throat.
I don't know, I'm sure Kaiba's around here somewhere doing his own investigating.
By himself?
I assume so.
I knew it. I totally knew it. I'm a total pro when it comes to all things master. Anyway, I gotta hurry. I can't even imagine how lonely he must be right now.
Toko shut off, her eerie laughter echoing behind her.
I totally forgot to ask her about the picture.
Well, there's no point asking Genocide Jack anyway. Besides, I have more important things to do right now.
Why did Toko faint?
There's gotta be some reason for it.
In the fridge, it's open.
I'm sure they're all shut tight last time I was here.
That must be why she passed out.
Right. She fainted so easily. Kyoko? It's getting late, isn't it? Are you okay?
Indeed.
I'm sorry if I made you worry. No, you don't have to apologize.
Listen.
But listen, about this room. Oh yeah, it's a morgue. Yeah.
I knew it.
I suspected as much. And Toko must have looked inside the fridge, seen what was in there, and... Well, there you have it. You mean you knew she'd fainted?
Indeed.
I was on my way here when Genocide Jack came running past me. I assumed she must have sneezed, but once I got here, the real reason became clear. I imagine she came here to investigate, and when she opened the slot there, that's when she saw the body inside and dropped like a bag of rocks. Why has everything got to be so difficult with her?
Anyway,
we should close it up. Don't want to leave it hanging open like that. Yeah, good idea. Give me a hand with this. Kyoko pushed the fridge, hands outstretched, but suddenly she stopped. What's wrong?
Listen.
Maybe we should wait a second before closing it. Huh? How come? Because Mukuro's body is in here. Mukuro's corpse? Mukuro's body's inside the fridge? Just like every other time, the mastermind probably brought it up here while in the class trial. The mastermind did it? Because they assumed we wouldn't be doing the class trial over again, I guess. You may be right. Either way, I can finally get a good look at the body. Oh, that's right, Kyoko didn't get a chance to check the body during the investigation. I need to do my own examination of the corpse as soon as possible. I'm going to find a clue this time, and I'm going to grab the mastermind by the tail. Okay, so what should I do?
So then.
Why don't you just wait over there? I'll let you know as soon as I'm finished. Just wait over there, huh? That's it? It's a fridge made for storing dead bodies. Can't do it, I can't look inside. Should I ask Kyoko about that group photo? After all, she's in it too. Don't let me interrupt your investigation, but I wanted to talk to you about something. What is it? It's about that announcement Monokuma made earlier. You mean the one about the hint or something? I didn't take him up on the offer. Huh? Why not?
Because
the only reason he gave us a hint at this point would be to confuse us, to cloud our judgment. I can solve this mystery on my own without whatever hints he may have to offer. That's a good point. I wish I could go back and do the same thing, but what's done is done, I guess. Standing here looking at her, I don't think she's hiding anything from me. Is she right? Did the mastermind forge that picture as a trap to confuse us? That's gotta be it, there's no other explanation. Yep. What did she say? It seems when the blue light comes on, the slot is occupied, yes. So when someone's in there, the blue light comes on. Looking around, the number of lights are on, including Mukuro's. There's 9 in all. 9. 9 lights? Oh wow. Okay. I think I've seen a topic like this somewhere before. Yes. Oh, it's the same one I found in the garden tool shed. And if I remember, that tarp had a stamp on it that said Biolab. That's the tarp that was used to help camouflage the murder in the garden. At some point, someone got it from the biolab and took it over there. Okay, Makoto, I'm done. Already? Jeez, that was fast.
Indeed.
Anyone can do good work if they go slow. In that spirit, I'll make my report brief. So, did you find anything?
Indeed.
I paid careful attention to the wounds and traces of blood, and it seems highly likely that the stomach wound and blow to the back of the head were inflicted after death. Really? The burnt tissue made things a little difficult, but I'm completely confident in my findings. So that means none of those were the fatal injury, right? So then what was the fatal injury? The only other option is those other wounds, but the file said they were old.
Is that right?
Where does it say that they're old? Huh? All the Monokuma file says that they were afflicted at least several days ago. I guess I don't see the difference. Well, the difference is immense, considering the impression they give. Mm-hmm. You seem to be equating several days old with simply old. However, but that doesn't quite follow logically. Old wounds seem like they've been there forever, like they're not related to the murder. You saying they are? But all we got was, but we all got the Monokuma file right after she was killed, right? So if the wounds were at least a few days old, there's no way they could have had anything to do with it. What if Ms. Kodoro herself wasn't killed within the last few days? Huh? At the very least. Certainly you can allow it as one of the many possibilities, right? Can't you? One of many? Right. A detective doesn't have supernatural powers. There's no way to predict the right... to predict the answer from the beginning. Ugh. I need to charge my phone. Ugh. Instead, the ideal detective begins by imagining as many possible scenarios as they can. In other words, they envision these possibilities without prejudice, without bias, using only their logic and common sense. Then, as they investigate, they test what they find against each of these possibilities. Of course, me telling you this doesn't mean you'll be any good at detective work. But beyond using that to solve this particular mystery, you should keep it in mind for the future. What else was there? What did she say? Envision possibilities without prejudice. Oh yeah, and then you test each one. Yeah, okay, of course. Come to think of it, there was one thing. Earlier when I was looking at the Mokuro's profile, this is the height and weight. 5 foot 7 inches, 97 pounds, vitals were 31, 22, 32. Did I get that all right? You remembered all that? They are indeed consistent with the corpse. So then. Indeed. And don't forget about the Fenrir tattoo. There's absolutely no mistake. Indeed. Our victim in this case is, without a doubt, Mukuro Ikusaba.
And?
Is that all you wanted to ask? Yeah, I think so. Then it looks like we have no further business with Mokuro's body. Let's get going, it's kind of chilly in here. Oh wait, we're not gonna put the body back? Don't you think it's kind of sad leaving it out like this?
Why?
Sad? Did you forget? She was our enemy once. A part of the ultimate despair. But she still got killed, she's still a victim.
Hey.
Have you ever heard the phrase, you reap what you sow? Well yeah, but still. You really are naive, you know that? It's really quite appalling. She could have abandoned me, but she decided to help me instead. So for someone like that, what does it mean to be naive? I think we've done all we can do here. Back to our separate investigations, yes? Ah, hold on. I still have one more thing to do. Something I need to talk to Kyoko about. I need to ask her about the pocketbook I found in that locker. If I don't do it now. Hey, Kyoko, I have one last thing. I know I shouldn't, but I feel like I have to ask.
What?
Go on then, out with it. Have you really not seen your dad even once since you got here?
What? So...
what do you mean? Well, you know those lockers on the second floor of the dorms?
Indeed.
I do, yes. But to get into any of the lockers, you need the handbook of wherever the locker belongs to. Actually, I managed to get them open using that emergency handbook. Anyways.
I see.
The one you found in the headmaster's hidden room.
And?
So, did you find anything worthwhile in the lockers? I found a pocketbook. And after looking through it, I think it must be your pocketbook.
Why is that?
What makes you say that?
Because...
Like I said, the only locker's owner should be able to get into it, right? I can't imagine those lockers belong to any of us. After all, we only got access to that area just recently. What I'm saying is there's no way I could have had access to any of those lockers. And even if I did have a pocketbook, why would I bother putting it in a locker? Everything you just said makes perfect sense, but there was something written inside. It was about the headmaster, your father.
If that's true,
could that mean that video is real too? Video?
Makoto,
I think everything is finally starting to fit together to reveal a cohesive picture. Although, I'm afraid that picture might be worse than anything you could have imagined. What are you talking about?
I
need to go investigate those lockers right now. I need to confirm what you said with my own two eyes. Oh, let me give you the headmaster's handbook, that way you can.
So
that won't be necessary. If I'm right about this, I shouldn't have any problem opening the locker with my own handbook. After all, it would seem that's my locker. Your locker?
Makoto.
If you watch this, it'll all make sense. A DVD. It says, Class number 78, Urgent Interviews.
So
I found it in that hidden room after you left.
Anyway,
I don't have time to explain exactly what I think it means, so just watch it and see for yourself. I think you'll realize exactly what it means. You'll understand why you found my pocketbook in a place where none of us have ever seen before. None of this makes sense right now, but I guess that means there's some important clue on this DVD. Interview DVD. Oh, and now it's my turn. Do you have a second to listen to me ramble? Ramble?
In other words,
so as it turns out, the arrangements I'd made didn't stick. What I mean is, I'm less and less sure of everything, even my own feelings. You're talking about your dad, right? I can never find the answers to the questions I wanted to ask for the rest of my life. And all because of the mastermind.
However,
but there's one thing I am sure of. When it comes to the mastermind, there's no room in my heart for forgiveness.
I
swore to destroy the mastermind. This is just one more reason to follow through on that. Kyoko's eyes burned with the fire of determination. They're good eyes. The determination to defeat the mastermind. It's strange to be confronted with his death and suddenly feel this way. I couldn't care less if my father had found happiness.
Why?
So why is it? Why does it bother me so much to know how he suffered? It's ridiculous. There's just no understanding it, I guess. She let out a small laugh as she said it, but her smile was filled with sorrow. So, that's it for my rambling. There's still much to do before I can consider my task complete. What a ramble. Yeah, you're right.
Hey.
But keep this in mind. There's only ever one absolute truth. Whether that truth serves justice or suffering, whether it's the greatest truth or the worst, what do you mean?
Makoto.
Even if the truth you uncover is filled with hopelessness, you still can't give up hope. Absolutely not, because all I can do now is keep moving forward. That's pretty much all I'm good at, you know? Indeed. Sorry if that was strange.
So then.
Anyway, I need to get going. I'll see you at the class trial. Even behind that final farewell, Kyoko was gone. I better get going myself. I got that DVD from Kyoko. I should head to the AV room to check it out. Kyoko said something about hopeless truth, but no matter what happens, I won't lose hope. Even if it's the worst truth in the world, I can't afford to lose. Is that Avery room here? That's the nurse's room. Avery room's over here. What's the name of this room? Avery. Okay, it's just Avery room. What does AV stand for again? Animation video? This should be able to play DVDs just fine. Well then, I better take a look. I took the DVD Kyoko gave me and put it in the player. It said that it was playing but nothing appeared on screen. I stared into the black of the monitor. It must have been only a few seconds, but to me it felt like an eternity. And then for all of a sudden, An image appeared. Sayaka? It took me by total surprise. I hadn't seen Sayaka in who knows how long, and there she was.
Okay then, are you ready to begin?
The voice I heard was of the man positioned on one side of the screen. It was the voice of a middle-aged man.
I do apologize, but I hope you don't mind if I record our conversation. I'm a little slow, you know. I never really got the hang of taking notes while having a conversation.
It sounded like he was trying to make a joke, but Sayaka's tense face didn't move a single millimeter.
So this video is meant to serve as a kind of contract substitute. It's not that I don't trust you guys. It's more like insurance. So please don't worry too much. Now then, let me get straight to the point. There is a chance that you may have to spend the rest of your life here in the school. Can you accept that?
You want me to accept that? Sayaka's obviously at a total loss. It made total sense. Who would agree to spending the rest of your life in the school? Except... what?
Thank you. And I'm sorry about all this. Well, I can promise you that I will do everything in my power to keep you safe. As the headmaster of Hope's Peak Academy, I give you my word.
As if on cue, that's why the video cut out. There was a lot I hadn't understood up until now. But this, only this. I simply couldn't comprehend what I'd heard. Because I know how much Sayaka wanted to get out of here. I know how much she wanted to escape and pursue her dreams with her friends again. She wanted that so bad she tried to frame me for murder. So, why? Why would she say yes to living here for the rest of her life? As I sat there thinking about it, I noticed a sudden light. On the monitor, the video that I thought was finished flashed back on screen. My eyes darted back to the screen. And if I was confused before, what I saw next pushed me right over the edge. Huh? What I saw was me. Impossibly, undeniably me.
So Makoto, before we begin, I should let you know that I'll be recording our conversation. Yes.
Me and the headmaster were looking at each other. He and I were having what seemed like a fairly normal conversation. But I, the I in the here and now, had absolutely no memory of it. I had no memory of even meeting the headmaster, much less sitting down to talk to him like this.
Shall we get straight to the point? Makoto, there's a chance you may have to spend the rest of your life here in the school. Can you accept that? Yes.
This can't be real. I said yes.
I'm sorry I'm putting you through all this.
Well, I mean, you don't have much of a choice, do you?
But I promise that as long as you're in this school, I will do everything I can to protect you. As the headmaster of Hope's Peak Academy, that's the very least I can do for you.
Once again, the video cuts out. From there, the video repeats the same scene again and again with the others. Kaiba. Toko. Hina. Everyone. They all said they agreed to live in the school forever. And then? Kyoko. Her interview with him had been recorded just as clearly. Without a doubt, she had met him. She sat down with the headmaster of Hope's Peak Academy, her father. And when he asked her his question, she answered the same as everyone else. She accepted the life within the school. Just as Kyoko's interview was wrapping up, the monitor suddenly went black. Huh? It wasn't just the monitor, the DVD player itself had apparently turned off. Which of course meant the DVD wasn't playing anymore. What the heck just happened? Oopsie, looks like it broke. Out of service. What? It just so happened to break just now? Now then. When doesn't matter. Failure can strike anywhere, anytime. That's what failure is, right? Failure, my ass. You cut the power on purpose. Well, whatever. Even if I watch this, the whole thing, it'll just be more of the same. He'd ask them the question, and they'd all say yes. I couldn't help myself. I let out a huge exasperated sigh, but as I did, I remembered something. Thing is, you should have went to the headmaster's room. His secret room. Put it in the computer. Because then Monokun would know. I fed the tomb when I woke up and I was asleep. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Convenient outcome. Something that seemed to obviously work in favor of the mastermind. So does that mean I've lost my memory too? What about the others? Have we all forgotten? Or... Okay, Mel. Now we're finally here. This is it. It's about to begin again. The class trial is going to start. The final class trial. The last time all our lives will be on the line. The last hope and despair on the line. Last time hope and despair on the line. I don't have a choice. I have to do this. Okay then. This is the end. Kore de owari da. I guess I'm the first one this time. You're early, Makoto. Does that mean you feel prepared? Yeah, for now at least. But where's everyone else? Why aren't they here yet? I mean, you solved the mystery of the school, so... Don't worry, I'm sure they'll be here soon. Just like she said. Kaiba! Kaiba? They arrived one after another. But they're all in the same state of shock. Hina? Hiro? Silence. And it wasn't any normal silence. It was a deafening silence of fear and suspicion. It was like the first class trial.
You called for me and so I appear. Oh, I'm on fire!
Strong, silent master is so wonderful, so cool, so hot. My loins are ablaze. Now, listen, everything will be just fine if you leave it to me. With my scissor sharp scissors in hand, I'll stab and gouge and shiv the master of evil. But I thought he couldn't kill anyone but adorable little boys. If it's what masters want, it can be a boy, girl, or anything in between. I can handle it. No human language can describe the disappointment. Yeah, let's get it. No human language can describe the disappointment I'm feeling right now. Is everyone here? Oh, and wearing a gloomy Gus faces, I see. Okay, well then, let's begin. This final class trial is going to be slathered in pitch black despair. Climaximum sorrow. You're right, this is the final class trial, and this time it'll be fair. What do you mean, this time? Stop! What do you mean, this time? Stop with all the slander. I'm a bear in good standing, you know. If there was a Mr. Fair Guy Universe contest, I'd take home the tiara every year. I'm gonna win this game super fair and square. And I'll make sure everyone watching at home knows that despair is mightier than the hope. Enough of your tedious drivel. Begin the trial already. Sure. Let's begin the trial already. I'll be waiting for you down below. So don't try and run away. Laughing as loud as ever, Monokuma disappeared.
Whatever.
In the name of my family.
This will be over in no time. With an inexplicable confidence, Kaiba was the first one into the elevator. One by one, the others followed. Nobody made eye contact, nobody said a word, they just disappeared into the elevator. They were all acting odd, like they're paranoid, suspicious of each other. But you know where that is, don't you? Yeah, I think so. Well, you can tell us all about it soon. At the class trial. You're right, I'm ready. Ready to win, right? Of course. I'm glad to hear you say that. And then Kyoko is aboard the elevator. I started making my way toward the opening, step after step, toward that gaping maw. I'd resolved this would be the last time. I repeated to myself that there was no fear, no mystery left. I pushed the anxiety down, calmed my trembling body. And finally, on steady legs, I passed the threshold and stood in the elevator. Without warning, it began to descend, deeper and deeper, deeper and deeper still, deeper and deeper. Okay, yep, we know. I closed my eyes and sight fell away. All sound too disappeared. Alone in the universe, I waited for the elevator doors to open for the last time. Ah, Mel, it's been a long, long ride, eh? We're finally gonna graduate. What could have been seconds or centuries later? I felt the gentle vibration of the elevator come to an end. And I slowly opened my eyes. This is the final trial site? What do you think? Isn't it just the perfect background for deciding a person's fate? It's a long-awaited last stage, the always exciting final boss battle. I'm gonna sit in on this one. I'll sit here, and I'll sit right here in the vacant 16th seat.
Chills, chills, chills.